Sri Padmanabha Swami Temple, the most important socio-cultural and religious icon associated with Thiruvananthapuram, was the core around which the old settlements grew. The fact that Thiruvananthapuram is one of the 12 Divyadeshams, or sacred regions of Malaynadu, sung in the hymns of the Vaishnava Alvars, pointed to the elevated status enjoyed by the temple since ancient times. The history of the origin of this temple is lost in time, but there are many popular legends associating the founding of the temple with Vilvamangalam Swamiya. Another popular oral tradition points to Saint Divakara as the one behind the consecration of the temple. Among historians about the antiquity of the temple, because the temple has mentions in ancient Sangam literature work and Silapathikaram. Nammalvar, the renowned Vaishnavite saint of the 9th century, describes Sri Padmanabha of Ananthapuram, the old name of Thiruvananthapuram. The temple rose to prominence during the reign of the Cheras and the Wayanad royals. However, other equally prominent kingdoms such as the Pandyas contributed lavishly by way of resources and land and valuables to Sri Padmanabha Swami. The modern history of the temple can be dated back to the 18th century when Aniram Thirunal Marthandavarma, the founder of the Travancore kingdom, instigated a thorough reconstruction of the ancient temple complex. The foundation stone of the eastern Gopuram was laid during the time of Adityavarman, during 1566 AD. However, the work couldn't be started because of constant conflict between the Madambimars and the royals. However, Marthandavarma wasted no time in gathering skilled laborers from around his kingdom. It is said that for the renovation works, 4,000 stone carvers, 6,000 laborers, and about 100 elephants lent their service. The stonemasons were from Madurai, Tirunelveli, and Trishnapalli regions. The temple is enclosed within a high fort-like wall with four gopurams oriented to the cardinal directions. The gopurams in the north, west, and southern sides are constructed in the traditional Kerala style. The eastern gopuram is constructed in line with the Dravidian style, as seen in the great temples in Tamil Nadu. The construction of the eastern gopuram, which commenced during the reign of Marthandavarma, was completed by his successor, Kartika Thirunal Ramavarma, also known as Dharmaraja. Besides this majestic gopuram, the Shivelipura and the Uttakal Mandapam were made in Marthandavarma's time and bear testimony to the skill of the stonemasons who made them. A gold-covered flag post was also installed. The majestic Kulashekara Mandapam was also built during Dharmaraja's reign. It should be noted that the reconstruction of the Sri Padmanabha Swami Temple, initiated during the reign of Aniram Thirunal Marthandavarma, was carried forward by the subsequent Travancore royals who venerated Sri Padmanabha Swami as their family deity. when it was re-established, became instrumental in the restructuring of the settlement pattern of the region. A fort wall was constructed around the temple complex. Inside the fort were erected the royal abodes as well as the agraharams for the many Brahmins associated with the temple. Markets were established to sustain the growing population, and new roads and channels were made to facilitate both inland and water transportation. The main roads were widened to accommodate royal and religious processions, transforming Thiruvananthapuram into a grand capital city.